The story of America is the story of an adventure that began with deep faith, big dreams, and humble beginnings. No one has ever achieved anything significant without a chorus of critics standing on the sidelines explaining why it can't be done. Nothing is easier or more pathetic than being a critic, because they're people that can't get the job done. But the future belongs to the dreamers, not to the critics. The future belongs to the people who follow their heart no matter what the critics say, because they truly believe in their vision. The success of your athletic program arriving on the big stage should be a reminder to every new graduate of just what you can achieve when you start small, pursue a big vision, and never, ever quit. You never quit. If I give you one message to hold in your hearts today, it's this: never, ever give up. There'll be times in your life you'll want to quit, you'll want to go home. Just never quit. Go back home and tell mom, dad, I can do it. I can do it. I will do it. You're going to be successful. I've seen so many brilliant people. They gave up in life. They were totally brilliant. They were top of their class. They were the best students. They were the best of everything. They gave up. I've seen others who really didn't have that talent or that ability, and they're among the most successful people today in the world because they never quit and they never gave up. So just remember that. Never stop fighting for what you believe in and for the people who care about you. Carry yourself with dignity and pride. Demand the best from yourself and be totally unafraid to challenge entrenched interests and failed power structure. The more people tell you it's not possible, that it can't be done, the more you should be absolutely determined to prove them wrong. Treat the word impossible as nothing more than motivation. Relish the opportunity to be an outsider. Embrace that label. Being an outsider is fine. Embrace the label, because it's the outsiders who change the world and who make a real and lasting difference. The more that a broken system tells you that you're wrong, the more certain you should be that you must keep pushing ahead. You must keep pushing forward. And always have the courage to be yourself. Most importantly, you have to do what you love. You have to do what you love. I've seen so many people, they're forced through lots of reasons, sometimes including family, to go down a path that they don't want to go down, to go down a path that leads them to something that they don't love, that they don't enjoy. You have to do what you love, or you most likely won't be very successful at it. So do what you love. America is better when people put their faith into action. No one is ever going to stop you from practicing your faith or from preaching what's in your heart. America is beginning a new chapter. Today, each of you begins a new chapter as well. When your story goes from here, it will be defined by your vision, your perseverance, and your grit. If anyone ever had reason to quit, to give in to the bitterness and anger that we all face at some point, hundreds of thousands of young hearts and souls have been enriched at Liberty and inspired by the Spirit of God. Now it falls on the shoulders of each of you here today to protect the freedom. Fortunately, you have been equipped with the tools from your time right here on this campus to make the right decisions and to serve God, family, and country. As you build good lives, you will also be rebuilding our nation. You'll be leaders in your communities, stewards of great institutions, and defenders of liberty. And you will be great mothers and fathers and grandmothers and grandfathers, loving friends and loving family members. You will build a future where we have the courage to chase our dreams no matter what the cynics and the doubters have to say. You will have the confidence to speak the hopes in your hearts and to express the love that stirs your souls. And you will have the faith to replace a broken establishment with a government that serves and protects the people. We must always remember that we share one home and one glorious destiny. Whether we are brown, black, or white, we all bleed the same red blood of patriots. We all salute the same great American flag. And we are all made by the same Almighty God. As you remember, what you have learned here at Liberty, as long as you have pride in your beliefs, courage in your convictions, and faith in your God, then you will not fail.